the European Union and the member states present in Fiji today, and notably France, Spain, United Kingdom and Sweden, thank the Fijian presidency of COP23 for hosting this event, and are encouraged by the high level and broad participation by the Pacific partner countries. The meeting has allowed for a very fruitful exchange on possibilities and challenges facing the Pacific region, as well as shared success stories. The EU and the Pacific have shared vision for a low-carbon, climate-resilient future. We commend the strong commitment by all Pacific Islands to lead the global climate discussion, helping the Pacific Island countries and territories to cope with the adverse impacts of climate change is a priority for the European Union. The European Union and its member states are firmly committed to the implementation of the Paris Agreement and are committed to holding the global temperature rise well below the 2 degrees and to pursue efforts to limit this increase to 1.5 degrees Celsius. To achieve this, strong global alliances will continue to be required. Europe stands by the landmark Paris Agreements and leads the way on its implementation through effective climate policies and strengthened cooperation to build strong partnership with all stakeholders. The EU is supporting an ambitious outcome at COP23 and considers a clear proposal on the preparation for the 2018 facilitative dialogue as key deliverable. The facilitative dialogue at COP24 will be a milestone for all stakeholders, an opportunity to take stock of what has already been achieved and means to increase ambition going forward. This meeting in the aftermath of the cyclone Winston and Pam has reinforced the message that Pacific small island states are just a storm away from the disaster. In this regard, we commend the work of the Pacific leaders for agreeing to the Framework for Resilient Development in the Pacific, an integrated approach to climate change and disaster. The European Union understands the great value of the Framework for Resilience Development in the Pacific and is firmly committed to its implementation. We are supportive of the development of innovative approaches to working closely with the private sector and linking the interest between private and public sectors and civil society on climate action. Indeed, mainstreaming of climate risk consideration and resilience across all policies, public and private investment and financing strategies, as well as civil society, emerged as a core recommendation of this meeting. The EU sees the Marrakesh Partnership for Global Climate Action playing an important role in catalyzing enhanced voluntary action by all stakeholders and helping to accelerate the implementation of current NDCs. Under the partnership, the EU supports initiative on disaster risk insurance in several Pacific countries in order to unleash the potential of insurance in dealing with extreme weather events, with the aim to upscale efficient disaster risk insurance solutions for the poor and most vulnerable populations. We are encouraged by the strong commitment of initiatives and coalitions to the action agenda in the Pacific region, in that it is part of a global moment which is gathering speed, where states and thousands of local authorities, business and investors are moving ahead with implementing the Paris Agreement. Through collaborative action and through the action agenda, knowledge can be shared and opportunities for accelerating climate action can be unlocked. We are encouraged by the open discussion on climate action to happen at the level of cities and towns and through integrated island approaches. We invite towns in the Pacific Islands to join international coalition, such as the Covenant of Mayors. We thank the Fijian COP presidency for pushing the action agenda further and wish them all the best for the important meeting at COP23 in Bonn. Honorable Minister,
the Deputy Head of Delegation for the Pacific, Your Excellency Mr. Corrado Pampoloni. Once again, thank you indeed for your encouraging remarks and your support of Fiji's efforts as President of COP23. We appreciate your focus on building resilience in the Pacific Island countries, which the EU has been a strong partner on this. And of course, we look forward, Excellency, to working with the European Union as we embark on the climate action program here in the Pacific. Thank you,
Mr. President.